What is nature's energy source and can we borrow some of nature's energy? In this video, I will tell you about the potential of bioenergy. Please note that a larger overview of different types of biomass will be discussed in the week dedicated to biomass in this course. My colleagues will introduce you to the technologies to create biofuel and how this form of chemical energy is converted into other forms of energy. For now, we will stick to a very rough estimation of the potential of biomass in the global energy mix. We start with the sun. All plants and trees on Earth use photosynthesis to convert solar energy into chemical energy in the form of carbohydrates. Fortunately, in this process, carbon dioxide is converted into oxygen as well. This makes our planet habitable for us humans and all other animals. The biomass is stored and then burned for either heating or electricity. Bioenergy exists in lots of forms: solids, liquids, and gases. An example of a solid fuel is wood. For ages, the burning of wood was the dominant energy source. Biomass, such as wood or agricultural residues, are burned in power plants to heat steam turbines and generate electricity. Other crops, like sugarcane and elephant grass, are produced to make liquid biofuels. Biomass can also be turned into gas. An example is the synthetic natural gas, which contains the burnable substance methane and is produced by the gasification of biomass. Another way of gaining methane is by the fermentation of the manure of livestock like cows and pigs. A picture of such a fermenter is shown here. Biomass is in liquid or gaseous form, requires more processing, but it makes the biofuels much more energy dense. A higher energy density makes storage of biofuels easier, since a smaller storage volume is required for the same amount of energy. Calculating the energy potential of biomass isn't very straightforward. It strongly depends on the energy content of the plant, which in turn depends on the condition in which the plant has grown. For this rough estimation, we'll take a step back and use the energy in sunlight as the primary energy potential. This is calculated using the equations introduced in the previous video. The output of plants is mainly determined by the photosynthetic efficiency of the crop and the conversion efficiencies in the power generation plants, where the thermal energy is converted into electrical energy. Additionally, depending on the type of biofuel, a chemical conversion step might be included, for example, sucrose to ethanol, which has its own conversion efficiency. A biomass power plant also has some practical losses, represented by its capacity factor. Two main factors influence the capacity factor. For one, the energy yield depends on the type of crop that is used. Secondly, the crop's growth is dependent on the external conditions like weather, which change over the course of a year. Now let's make estimation of potential for electricity from wood per square meter. Biomass takes its energy from solar irradiation. Yearly irradiation in North America is around 1500 kilowatt hours per square meters per year. Plants have an average of photosynthetic efficiency between 0.1% and 2%. Let's assume that wood has a photosynthetic efficiency of 0.4%. The wood is burned and the heat is used in a conventional steam turbine for electricity generation. We consider that the thermal conversion efficiency is about 25%. This means that the energy yield of this plant is 0.004 times 0.25 times 1500, which equals to a total of 1.5 kilowatt hour per square meter per year. The average power production is therefore equal to 0.70 watt per square meter. Next, we will consider biofuels. Brazil has a big sugarcane industry for the production of bioethanol. The average solar radiance in Brazil is roughly 230 watts per square meter. Let's assume a very high photosynthetic efficiency of 1.5%. Unfortunately, not all carbohydrates can be used for the conversion to ethanol. Only the carbohydrate sucrose can be converted into ethanol. 30% of the chemical energy in the sugarcane is stored in sucrose. The conversion efficiency of sucrose to ethanol can be as high as 75%. During this simple math, we arrive at a final power density of 0.78 watts per square meter. What is the capacity factor of a biomass plant? Currently, the largest biomass-fired power plant in the world is the Drax Power Station in the United Kingdom. It has a total installed capacity of 3,960 megawatts, of which 1,320 megawatts is powered using biomass. The power station uses all kinds of wood products that are imported from North America and has an energy yield of 7.9 terawatt hours per year. The capacity factor can be calculated by dividing the energy yield by the nominal production multiplied by the number of hours in a year. This results in a capacity factor of 68%. Bioenergy is currently a hot topic. Let's quickly discuss the pros and the cons. A big advantage of biomass, of course, is that it can be stored. Secondly, biomass can be burned in conventional power plants, and ethanol can be used almost the same as gasoline in combustion engine in cars, planes, and other vehicles. Integration of certain biofuels therefore requires minimal changes in the energy infrastructure. Finally, the energy density in ethanol is a lot higher than that of, for example, electric batteries. Biomass also has some disadvantages. The first generation biomass, such as sugarcane, is in competition for land and water with crops cultivated for food. The latest generation, however, like algae, doesn't have this limitation. Secondly, the net energy gain of some biofuels can be very low. The energy balance of the converting corn into liquids like palm oil and bioethanol can even become negative. This means that more energy is used in processing, transportation, land use, and fermentation than is finally stored in the biofuel. These aspects can affect the carbon footprint of bioenergy. Even though biomass can provide a renewable source of energy, it is definitely not a clean source of energy. The burning of biofuel produces greenhouse gases, which poses a major global challenge. Also, the poison and fertilizers used to grow the crops can have adverse effects on the environment. Additionally, because the processing of a lot of sources of bioenergy is very energy intensive, the carbon footprint is also very high in comparison with other renewable energy sources. Let's consider biomass at a global perspective. If you only look at the installed capacity of biopower for electricity generation, the global capacity is then 93 gigawatts. This is good for 433 terawatt hours per year. Globally, this leads to 158 watt hours per person per day. However, the major part of bioenergy is not converted into electricity, but is used for heating purposes. The total installed thermal capacity on Earth is 305 gigawatt, producing a little more than 2,300 terawatt hours per year. This results into 840 watt hours per person per day. Biomass deals with low efficiencies, which results into a power density of 0.1 to 0.3 watts per square meter. Therefore, its area to cover the world's energy demand is just shy of that of hydro energy. To conclude, biomass is a renewable source of energy that can help the world with its storage needs and can easily be integrated in the current energy infrastructure. However, its net energy gain is low and it's not a clean source of energy with a relatively high carbon footprint. In the next video, we will look into geothermal energy.